Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu4Java, and this is tutorial number 4 of Spring Framework. In this tutorial, I want to continue with tutorial number 2. We had created a container, if you remember. The container was a bit ugly because it had news. It created the objects. Let's run the application to remember. Main, run us, Java application. He's using mail delivery service. If we want to change mail delivery service for electronic delivery service, we will have to modify the code. This one. Recompilate the application. Well, this is made by Eclipse automatically, but if we didn't have Eclipse, we will have to do it. Let's run it again. And here we have electronic delivery service. We also talked about using a file. In the last tutorial, we said that Spring uses an XML file. We could modify the container so that ours also works with a file. The idea is that we can modify this method, which is in the one which creates the hash map, with another implementation, this one. Here I have a problem. This was because I had an orthographic mistake. Okay. I now have to make the import, so I'm going to use the properties of java.util. Here what I'm doing is when I'm going to load the hash map, I'm going to fetch it in a properties call context.properties, which I'm going to define. We should create this file dot properties. Because of this file input stream, by default it is going to fetch it to the root of our project. File. This is the name we're going to put it, context.properties. Inside this context.properties, we're going to put the information of which beans we want to create. This hash mark here means comments for a properties file. This file has a special format. Name equals value. Name of the properties equals value of the properties. Let's write first the name of the beans, delivery service, and customer relation office. They are the name of the beans. On this other side, we put the name of the classes. Below, we're going to put the properties to be set. Customer relation office, which has a property delivery service. We separate them with a dot. We want to put inside this property a delivery service, which would be this object here. Okay, let's go back to the container. Here we have this properties file. When we load these properties, we start to go through them. The first thing I do is to go through them, and I ask if the property has a dot. I look for a dot, and if the search for the dot is less than 0 because there is no dot, it comes inside here. I create a bean with this value here. This value here, the value of the property. Properties dot get property key. This, and once I have this value, I make a class dot for name, which loads the class. The one I tell him. It's going to load this class. It's like making an import, really. Once we load it in memory, I can execute the method newInstance to the class. And it creates an instance. I save the object created in the variable bean, and in components I save it with key. With this key, I'm going to save in the hash map an object of this class. The second time, it would do it for this one and for this one. As I don't save the file, I delete it and it disappears from the properties. And here. Once I have all of them loaded, I have iterated looking for the ones of this type. The ones which had a dot will be in the properties. When I start iterating over them, I'm going to do it over the ones which had a dot. I only have one here. Here, split separates the content of key. This one. It separates it by a dot. This is an escape character. Here it wasn't necessary because it is a chart, and to write a dot in a string we have to use an escape character. What I'm saying here is to separate the key depending on where is the dot. It's going to give me two strings. The first one, which will be the this name here, this one, with this name. I'm going to look for this name in the table where these components are. Here, we're going to have this object. I'm going to have this object here in receptor bean. It will be the bean in which we'll be set the property. The name of the property is the second one. And the third one will be the bean to be inserted, the bean to be injected. Properties.getKey. Here I'm getting what is in this side. This name. And I ask for the component which is in the hash map. And this is going to be the bean to be injected. This function is given by Apache, and let us give a bean, a receptor bean, a name for the property, and another bean. And what it does is, in this bean, it looks for this property. If there is a set method with the name of the property and injects these objects to use this property, we have to import it. In the last tutorial, we downloaded a Spring version which comes with other libraries. Inside these other libraries, add external hard jar, we're going to find libraries. If we look for Jakarta Commons and two libraries, Commons Logging, yes. And let's see, the other one was Commons Bean Utils. Here it is, Commons Bean Utils. We import the login because it is used by this one. Let's see what happens now. Ctrl Shift O to import. Here it is. Let's try this new modification. Let's go to main, run as Java application. Okay, we have an error. This mini container, the mini containers in the package, and here the package is container, not mini container. This mini here is not correct, and this one too. Run, Another error. Here it says that it can't instantiation exception. It can't instantiate this class, customer relation office. It can't create it because I put a construction with a parameter delivery. And we are building it without parameters. Okay, I delete it, save, and run again. Here it is, electronic delivery service. It's getting the objects which is going to use directly from the configuration file. Context.properties. The container reads the context.properties and creates the objects. If we want to change the electronic service for the mail, we just have to change it in the configuration file. And here you can see now electronic delivery service, we run it again and we have mail. We change this class for this one without changing anything in the code. The container was configured through a configuration file. And we just had to change it. We didn't have to compilate anything. If this was in production already, it doesn't have to be sent back to development to change the code. We just have to change the configuration file and it works. Okay, this is all for this tutorial. See you in the next one.